Hey, it's me, Lola. Listen, your prices for your products and services should be between 15 to 30% more than the cost it takes you to produce them. That is for a good or a service that you provide. That's a good number, right? But that leaves me with this question. How do you know how to price your actual cost? How do you know how to quantify that or measure it up with a set of numbers? I'm going to tell you how to price your products and services in a way that helps you feel more confident, more secure, and so that you don't sell yourself short or feel like you have to apologize for these prices you're setting. So your prices for products and services should be between 15 to 30% more than the cost it takes you to produce them. You do that so that you can turn a profit. You do that so that you can actually make money. But how do you figure out what your costs are? Especially if you're someone who's not producing an actual physical good or product. If you're someone that's in a service-based business where you're selling your knowledge or you're selling your creativity, it may be a little bit different. But don't worry, I'm going to take the difficulty out of the process today and tell you how to do it. Now, the first thing that we'll start with is what you don't want to do when it comes to setting your prices. The number one thing that you don't want to do is set prices that are based on self-worth, yours or your clients. Don't do that at all. And that may look like you saying, I don't think I deserve this amount. Or it may look like you saying, this person can't afford it. Or a client telling you, hey, I can't afford that, okay? So these are all indicators that worth and esteem is coming into play. And when that happens, you just have to remember that there is a cost to you producing whatever you're doing, whether it be a product that's physical or whether it be something that is a service that is not physical. There's a cost. And you have to make money so that you can cover your costs. So if you run into this, I want you to just start saying daily on a regular basis that one, the people you're called to can afford to pay you. And not only that, they are more than willing to do so. They are happy to make that investment in themselves, their future, and the life that they want. Okay, so three things I want you to consider off top when it comes to setting your prices for a good, a service, or a product that you make. So my husband Dante has this formula for coming up with prices for products and services. It includes a few things that I'm not going to share with you today. Now I am going to reveal three things to you, but everything I'm not going to tell you because he's going to do that over on the podcast. If you want to hear it, you can go to the Smoking Profit podcast and subscribe. And once that podcast comes out, you'll receive the alert about it. Don't worry if you aren't into listening to podcasts. We'll also put some episode notes on thesmokingprofit.com so you can go and read it, which I like that option because you can always go and just scan and pull out what you need when you need it. All right, but let me go ahead and get back into it. Three things that I want you to consider every time it comes to you thinking about how much you're going to charge someone for your creativity, for your knowledge, for a skill that you have. The first thing is going to be your education. This is you investing in formal or informal education, college, certifications, on-demand courses, master classes. This is you taking your time out, taking your money, taking your energy, your focus to learn something so that it makes you more marketable and makes you more competitive, okay? The next thing that I want you to think about is going to be your expertise. This is your level of mastery in a particular industry. Now, your mastery levels are going to vary between four things. You can be a novice, a beginner. You can be more intermediate with your skill level. You can be more advanced, or you can hit that like top-notch mastery level where you're expert, where you're leading, you're teaching, you know, where you are just banging it out doing. You know, those are your mastery levels. Think about that when it comes to pricing. Now, the last thing I want you to do is think about your experience. This is gonna be your direct, on-the-job, hands-on work experience in a particular field, in a particular industry. Those are three things that you need to think about at minimum when it comes to you pricing your products and services, especially when you have a skill that is not so measurable, when it's something like creativity or something like knowledge. that you're giving out to someone. Does that sound good for you? Okay, those are three things to start with. But the biggest thing I want you to remember is what not to do, which is never ever base your prices for products and services on self-worth, yours or your clients, because the people you're called to can afford to pay you and they are willing and happy to do so. If you have not subscribed to the Smoking Profit Podcast, go ahead and do that now. As I mentioned, my husband Dante is gonna share a formula that we use to set prices, and I think it will help you set your prices so that you're happy, so that you feel confident, so that you feel secure, and so that you never ever have to apologize for a price that you set. Let me go ahead and wrap this thing up. I'm Lola, creator of The Smoking Prophet, which is a life advice brand designed to help resource you spiritually, creatively, and socially. So if you haven't been over to our blog or podcast, go ahead and do that now. And I'm gonna go ahead and get off of here. Until next time, I hope you have the most amazing life. Bye! Spiritually, creatively, socially, spiritually, creatively, socially, do life, do life, do it better, do it better, do life, do life, do it better, do it better. The Smoking Prophet will inspire and equip you. The Smoking Prophet takes your skills and gifts and molds you.